schools. Motivating achievement since 1906.
Welcome to the Humboldt Experience. I am Court Miner, the proud principal of Brash Mountain High School. I am filling in today for our superintendent, Mr. Dan Streeter. Today we have student spotlights featuring Brash Mountain High School students Timmy Young and Alexis Burkett. We're real excited to put a spotlight on students. We're kind of changing the format up, if you will, and we're spotlighting some of our kids around the district. Right now, I would like to jump into our November VIPs from Lake Valley Elementary School. Certified Jackie Hamrick. And here's what was said about Jackie. Ms. Hamrick is a teacher that shows genuine care, support, and dedication for her students. She has a knack for working with students at all ability levels. She's able to make connections with students that contribute to building a trusting relationship where the students know she is there to support them. Ms. Hamrick also takes time daily to do classroom meetings where she works to build her classroom culture, her students' social, emotional growth, and to create a place where students feel safe. Ms. Hamrick consistently sees high levels of growth from her students. She's a lifelong learner. She searches out opportunities for new learning and loves to share new ideas. She's the first one to sign up when PD is available and the first one to go into her classroom and try these new ideas. When she teaches, she uses her heart and her soul behind all she does. Oftentimes, Ms. Hamrick is seen as one of our weekend warriors. It is not uncommon to see her at school on the weekends prepping, readjusting groups, or creating new activities for her students to try. She is a well-prepared and a very well-organized teacher who knows the hard work and dedication it takes to be a highly effective teacher. Ms. Hamrick is always involved in our school community as well. She's a member of our PTA, site council, and comes to all our family nights. Our community and families see and appreciate the drive and dedication that she puts into everything she does at Lake Valley High School. Again, congratulations to HUSD Classified Employee of the Month from Lake Valley, Jackie Hamrick. For Classified, we have Ms. Tricia Walker. Ms. Walker is a staff member that has a strong, positive impact on Lake Valley. She is the first line of contact that our parents and families see each day. She has such a high level of customer service that ensures anyone that walks into the office is greeted, receives superior customer service, and feels that their concerns, thoughts, or questions are not only answered, but genuinely heard and mattered. Ms. Walker is bilingual and enthusiastically reaches out to our parents to ensure that they feel comfortable and that communication is not a barrier for them when they walk into Lake Valley. Ms. Walker oftentimes stays after or comes before work to translate for families and to talk with them for long periods of time to ensure they understand and know that they are an important factor in their students' education. She has a warm feel interactions with students, families, and all staff. She has a great sense of humor that keeps our office area lively and exciting. She has a contagious laugh that makes everyone laugh with her. She is able to be highly productive, yet keep the overall tone light and fun at the same time. She is also involved and invested in the school. As we said earlier, she's a member of the PTA. Her husband is a board member of PTA, and her son also attends Lake Valley, which show how much she and her family value our school, our students, and our families. So again, congratulations to our Classified Employee of the Month from Lake Valley, Ms. Patricia Walker. This is kind of a big deal here. Our volunteer, HUSD VIP volunteers, was the entire PTA board, which is Nikki Indikovich, who's president, Michelle Bratt, who's the vice president, Becky Johnson, secretary, Rob Walker, treasurer, Michaela Janowski, teacher's liaison, Sarah Weathersby, hospitality chair, Sheila Alif, the fundraising chair, and Teka Hull, who's the volunteer coordinator. And here's some nice comments, again, about the PTA board members at Lake Valley Elementary School. This wonderful PTA board is on our campus every week and many times, multiple times a week. They come and volunteer their time for school events, fundraisers, classroom projects, help for teachers, and even a little surprise treat days for our staff. They have made our staff and families feel so supported and valued that the culture and closeness of our campus has risen tremendously. One of the most important things that we can say about the PTA group is their heart, soul, and support is with Lake Valley. No matter the call, email, or request that is put before them, they come running to support Lake Valley. There is no time that the staff members have ever come to them and they have not been willing to offer full support. It is an amazing feeling to know that when you need this group, they come running and willing with a group of parents behind them. Personally, many of the ideas or successes that have happened this year have happened due to the commitment of the Lake Valley PTA board members. Our staff, students, family, and community are our staff, students, families, and community are made a better place due to the dedication of this PTA board. So congratulations to the Lake Valley Elementary School PTA board members for their volunteerism at the school. With that being said, we're going to jump into the main point of today, and that is some of our students that we have here from Brasher Mountain High School. And being the principal at Brasher Mountain High School, I'm really excited that we get to spotlight some of our kids. And first off, I got to start with a senior. We're going to start with Alexis Burkett. And Alexis, it's your senior year. You're involved in drama, and obviously involved with all the plays, all the stuff in behind the scenes of the plays, et cetera, all the competitions that you guys do. Tell me a little bit about your high school experience.
Well, as a freshman, I knew right away that I wanted to be in drama, and I auditioned for the first show that we did with our first new drama teacher after our other one left, Mr. Pyduck, actually.
Yes.
Ms. Russell, who's wonderful and is so dedicated to the program. And the first show that we did was called And Then There Were None by Agatha Christie. And I did tech for that show. It wasn't a very tech-heavy show, so easy job for me. And then after that, we did Get Smart. And then my sophomore year was other shows. And I've been in every show up until now. And the show that we just did was A Christmas Story, our Christmas play. We've never done a Christmas one before. And it was a lot of fun. The whole auditorium was emblazoned with Christmas decorations, and it was beautiful. And actually, the choir director at the middle school asked us to leave the decorations there because she thought they were so pretty. And this last week was straight rehearsals and performances for A Christmas Story, and it was crazy. I didn't get home till like 10-ish every night.
Yes.
And other actors had way more lines than me and worked way harder, so I'm super proud of them. And how hard they worked. And so for me, my high school experience has been theater and trying to keep up with my grades at the same time and setting up different competition pieces. And it's been really fun, but stressful.
Well, tell us a little bit about those competition pieces and the accolades that you received this year.
Well, recently we went to State Festival, which is at the Phoenix Convention Center, and all the schools in Arizona send their drama troupe there. We are Troupe 6017, and I competed in two categories. The first one was our class one act, or troupe one act, called This Is a Play, and it was hilarious and constantly broke the fourth wall, and there was only three actors. Myself, Jasmine Jeffries, and Tristan Anderson, who are my wonderful co-actors and friends. And also Corbin Young was also in it. Couldn't forget him. And our techie, Tyler Manabusan, who's wonderful at his job. We received, I believe, three superiors out of the five, and the other two were excellents for that show, which was really gratifying and awesome, and it was really fun to work on. And then the other thing that I competed in was group musical. It was a song called Anything Goes from the musical, Anything Goes. The dance I choreographed and directed myself with four other people, and it took forever. We've been working on it since October. Or no, not October was when we performed it. We have been working on it since August, actually, is when I started making up the dance. And we worked really hard as a group to meet up. But
what happened? What'd you guys get?
We received two superiors and three excellents out of the five categories. And the two superiors were in the two things I was really proud of, is the dancing that I made up mostly
practice
by myself. And the other one was in the characterization. We all spent time deciding what characters we wanted to be. I think I was like the cool one, the leader one, since I was in the center for a lot of it, which was only fair since I choreographed it myself.
Well, it's your senior year. It's going to fly by. We know that. What do you plan on doing after high school?
I want to go to Yavapai College to major in education, primary education. I would love to be a kindergarten teacher or a first grade teacher at Lake Valley, which you talked so much about, all the wonderful teachers they have there. I would love to be one of those teachers. I went there, and everyone there is so supportive of every little tiny issue that these blossoming children have, and they all work so hard, and they don't get paid enough, and that's not fair. And the schools just don't get enough funding, and so what I would love to do is to be a teacher while working towards better pay for teachers somehow. I mean, if it's using all my students to write petitions to the senator or whoever, I just want to show my appreciation for all the teachers who were there for me and there for each other when they were going through such hard times when I was a student. Like, for a while, we didn't have any printing paper. And teachers were like begging parents to bring paper to school. And this the hard work that these people put into their jobs is insane.
Well, you like to give back. That's the big thing I'm hearing from, is you like to give back. And I know Lake Valley would love to have you back. But I appreciate some of the things that you said there, because quite often at the high school, we kind of get the credits, if you will, you know, for kids, their freshman, sophomore, junior, senior, and the stuff they do after high school. And it really is a K-12 picture. Mm-hmm. It really is, you know, those formidable years in elementary school through the middle schools, and then, you know, getting that exposure and those opportunities when you're in high school and taking advantage of them. So I really appreciate the kudos you gave back to Lake Valley, and hopefully in 4 years-ish, 5 years-ish, I'll see you back in the district. That'd be really cool. Well, thank you for all your involvement in school and all the great things you do. I do want to say, you know, you mentioned that you, you were a sound tech. Is that what you said in the first play?
I was properties chief.
And you said it was a pretty easy job.
Yeah.
Well, take a look at this last weekend's Christmas Story with the set, with the sound, with the special effects, with the lighting. Boy, have we come a long way in the last 3 years, haven't mm-hmm. we?
Yes.
Well, thank you for your time, Alexis. We're going to hop over to Mr. Tim Young. Timmy's a junior at Bradshaw Mountain High School. Timmy, tell us about your high school experience and the importance of getting involved in the things that you've been involved with.
Well, my high school experience has been all sports. I've played 3 sports. I played basketball, football, baseball. I'm also involved in choir, which is so much fun. Miss Van is just an amazing teacher. She brings light to everyone's day. My freshman year in choir, actually, coming around January, we do something called the regional auditions for choir. And I tried out my freshman year not expecting to make it or anything. I actually went there, did barely knew my song, but I auditioned because Ms. Van told me. She's like, audition, you'd be good at it. So I went and I auditioned. I got a third alternate, which didn't mean I didn't get to go, but it's still awesome being third alternate. And then
being recognized.
Yeah, and then last year I made it, so I was like the last person to make it. It was the bottom of the bar, but it was so much fun. We had the director from NAU. She came down and directed the regional choir, and she was a very good director. Learned a lot of stuff from her. And freshman year football, we did a lot of stuff that year. We had a like 13 kids, I think, at one point of the season.
At the end of the year, yeah.
Yeah, which you play with 11, so it's not that many subs, but it was awesome just bonding with everybody and seeing who stuck around to this year, where we went to the playoffs, and all the juniors that were still there with me were from freshman year. It was really fun. Nice to play with them again. And basketball season's coming along. Still trying to pick something up, but it'll get there.
I know we're working on scoring right now.
Yeah.
Definitely have the athleticism. We're working on putting that ball in the hoop.
Yeah.
Right? We're struggling with that a little bit. But how do you juggle all that stuff? I mean, choir has practices. Choir, I mean, I know it meets during the school day, but you have after school performances. and productions like that. Next week you have one coming up, the winter one. Mm-hmm. How do you balance playing all the sports? You've taken pre-AP courses, you've taken some AP courses. How do you balance all the school stuff, all the sports stuff, all the choir stuff?
Very difficultly, if I could say that. Well, with all the sports going on, sports is a huge role in my life. I've played sports since I was 4 years old, so that's my main priority, is make sure I get sports. So in the after-school practices, if it's a sports or it's choir, I pick sports over it some days. So like during Pops, so like Pops is the end of the year concert, it's huge. We have mandatory rehearsals. So what I do is I try to get that those days to my coach in advance, see if we have any games. If we have any games, I go to the game. But if we don't, I go to the choir practice because it's mandatory. It's four grade. I need to be there to practice my part. But it's really, it goes school, sports, and then choir. So I just go get my work done, and then I go to my sports practices, and then choir practices. And what's really nice is the choir concerts are usually at night. Right. So usually around the 6:45, 7 o'clock time, which is really nice because it's right after practice, so I just head right over there.
So when are you doing homework, Timothy?
Late. It's usually practice for me gets out usually around 5, 5:30, and then I go home, and then I usually do homework right after when I get home, unless I'm not eating dinner, because dinner trumps homework, so... but usually around 8:30, 9, anywhere in there sometimes. Sometimes later, like concert nights, it's like 10:30, 11.
Exactly.
And then you got to get up for my 0 hour the next morning.
I would have to say for both of you, you guys definitely have had to learn some time management through high school.
Yes.
I joke around with the seniors all the time, but I let them know you guys are so busy, you guys are so involved, that when you go to college, it will be easier. I promise. You know, focus. Get to focus more about what you're doing and what your majors are and what you want to get involved with. I asked Alexis, obviously, she's a senior and you're a junior, so I know obviously you'll be at Bradshaw Mountain High School, but next year in your senior year when you finish up, what would you like to do after high school?
After high school, I'd like to go to college and play some football. That's my main goal. I've had that goal ever since I was little.
But Division I, Division II, Division III, NAIA, it doesn't matter as long as you can play football?
As long as I'm playing, it doesn't matter for me. But I've always thought of a backup plan. And when I was little, it was always engineering or architecture. Well, I found out that architecture is kind of it's very time-consuming, and it gets boring sometimes. There's not a lot of creativity and like different stuff, especially if you're in a city doing architecture.
Yeah. Urban planning is a cookie cutter.
So I'm leaning to going in engineer major. You're either like aeronautical engineer or a nuclear engineer would be fun. But my plan is, if I don't make anywhere for football, I was gonna go through the Air Force to get my schooling done for engineering in the Air Force.
Well, nice. Well, it sounds like both of you plan on giving back through the military, through teaching. Those same teachers that made the impression on you, Alexis, you get that opportunity to give back. I'm not going to lie to you, that's why I got into education. I said some of those teachers, some of those people out there, that just made a difference for me. And, you know, kicked me in the pants when I needed to and patted me on the back when I needed them to. And Tim, I couldn't have done any of my stuff without playing baseball and playing, you know, sports through college. Helped with scholarship, helped with financial aid, helped with all those things. And so good luck to both of you. This is our first time spotlighting on students, so we're pretty excited. Hopefully you've enjoyed hearing Alexis and Tim talk a little bit about their experience at Bradshaw Mountain High School. We look forward to maybe down the road following up with Tim, see what he's doing his senior year, and maybe in 5 years or 6 years, we could have Miss Burkett here on the Humboldt Experience as a second grade, third grade teacher. How cool would that be? Before we wrap things up, I've got some quick announcements that I'd like to give a shout out to. The Family Resource Center is in need of donations of new or gently used shoes, new socks, and winter hats and gloves. Donations are accepted at the district office, located at 6411 North Robert Road. If you would like additional information about the Family Resource Center, please call Margaret Drennan, Family Resource Specialist, at 759-5104. I want to remind you, winter break is coming. Friday, December 3rd is a two-hour early release day. Winter break is December 6th through January 6th. School resumes, and second semester begins on Monday, January 9th. Kind of a nice break that we have this year. Due to limited campus staff over the holidays, please call the school office prior to making any visits. Hours of operations will be posted on the office doors and the school website. The district office will be closed December 26th and December 27th and January 2nd, but will observe regular hours on all other business days during the week. Fingerprinting hours for volunteers. Just one reminder, we always can use more volunteers in our district. That's Tuesdays and Fridays from 10 a.m. to 12 noon at the district office. It does take 4 to 6 weeks for clearance. Important dates, just want to remind everybody, December 14th is a one-hour release, December 21st is a one-hour release, and December 23rd is a two-hour early release and the end of second semester. And just one more time, winter break is December 26th through January 6th, and school resumes January 9th. Again, my name is Court Miner. I'm the principal of Brasham Mountain High School, filling in today for Superintendent Mr. Dan Streeter. I hope you've enjoyed the Humboldt experience as much as we have and our spotlight on our students. Have a great day.
The Humboldt Schools, motivating achievement since 1906.